Hi, it's Susan Winter. Thank you for coming back to my channel, subscribers. I really, really appreciate it. And my clients and followers, please know how grateful I am to have you in my family of YouTube followers and podcast listeners. Today, I want to talk about something a little bit off topic for some of you and very much on target for many of you. I want to talk about the spiritual playa. Yeah, spiritual players. I want to illuminate the difference between how we perceive finding a partner who is spiritual like you are and the reality of that concept. So firstly, let me begin with the fact that I do have a spiritual life, but I live in this world, the practical world, the real world, and I want my spirituality to be functional and real. I hear so many people through consultation or in a group session tell me that they want a spiritual partner. I need to have a spiritual partner. So this is number one. This is the main request. I want a spiritual partner. I understand that you want somebody who honors and values the precepts that are important to you. And if you have an integrated spiritual life, this is a part of who you are. It is a philosophical choice. It is how you perceive life, how you negotiate your participation in life. And it is, truthfully, important that the partner you choose romantically backs you up in this and supports you. You don't have the luxury of having somebody who's constantly going to contest you. So they don't have to believe what you believe. And that's the thing that's a little tricky here. When you're choosing a mate, I don't want you to think that you have to have somebody who only believes what you believe. They just need to give you latitude to have your beliefs. That's it. Not make fun of you, not condemn you, not look down upon you, but if anything, to respect you for the kind of person that you are and how you're trying to show up in the world. So that's number one. That is understandable. But now let's talk about the type of people that you can find in this umbrella of a category. One of the most open terrains for manipulation, scams, cons is the spiritual realm. Because let's face it, there's no SEC to overlook it. Nobody can prove anything. Nobody can prove anything. Science is trying to prove some of the things that we understand that are happening, like thoughts are things and energy. But you're in a realm that already is beyond the Wild West. So this makes it difficult. Starting point, I want somebody who's spiritual. One, probably why you want that is because you think they're going to play nice and follow the rules of somebody who has higher consciousness and thoughtfulness. What you're asking for is loving, respectful behavior. Somebody who is conscious and aware and living on a higher level, trying to better themselves. Yes, a growth mindset and a kind mindset. Those are great, great goals. But people can hide out in this profession and use the lingo and use all the things and the kind of vague smiles and the airy eyes, you know, that just look so, and not be about that at all, okay? There's some great posers. Some are unconscious of the fact that they're posing. They just think that's the attitude they need to have. And others are very conscious of the fact that they're posing. So if you think that by choosing somebody who claims they're spiritual means you're safe, you're not safe. You're not safe. You don't know that you're safe. Because in all of love, no matter how it's constructed, you stand the likelihood of being hurt at some time. That's the negative and positive, the light and dark. That's the pro and con. That's the day and night. That is reality. Life, death, birth, growth, you know, all this. It's the totality of the experience. So please don't automatically assume that this person is never going to harm you and that they're held to certain principles. I would ask instead number two, the why, meaning why do you want somebody spiritual? In Susan language, that would be, what is the thing under the thing? That's what you're going for, the thing under the thing, meaning I'm looking for somebody ethical. I'm looking for somebody honest. I'm looking for somebody who can love deeply. I'm looking for somebody to honor me. I'm looking for somebody to grow with who has a beautiful vision of life. Now, when you start to look at those qualities, you could just as easily do what I often suggest to my clients. Just find a really decent human being. They don't have to do yoga. They don't have to meditate. They don't have to do any of these things. They might be completely unaware of this, but they love you and they're an inherently good, kind human being that already lives by a very specific code of behavior because it's who they are. In the fiber of their being, they are a good human. So for all you that say they have to be spiritual, they have to be spiritual, what you're really saying is, I need a good human being. And that is evident in everything they do, because everything they do is representative of everything they do. If they're nice to everybody, they're thoughtful, they're kind, straight across the board, they're going to be that way with you. Okay, so don't get hung up on they have to be spiritual. And another thing that you need to know about the spiritual player is that there's a lot of latitude to blame you for something that they did, because you're already in a realm where the rules are kind of squishy. Unlike formal religion that has a precise interpretation, spirituality has a lot of wiggle room. It's perceived how you perceive it, yes? And you cherry pick the kind of beliefs that you want. And so you could just as easily find somebody that misconstrues everything, does a turnaround, and kind of spiritually gaslights you when you call them out on something and blames you for not being, you know, accepting or not being loving or not being tolerant or not being understanding. This can happen. All right. And you don't have a lot of footing underneath you because you're already living in this bubble of how it's going to be. This is not to tell you to not look for somebody who's spiritual. This is simply telling you that what you are looking for is a fine human being who has values and a way of behaving that is in alignment with you and supports you in your journey of expansion and self-awareness and growth. That's it. So there are just as many cons in this field as there are in others. So please understand that when you meet that really charming, that hot guy in yoga class, he's so good looking, you can't figure out why he doesn't have a girlfriend and everybody wants him. Buyer beware, there's something going on. Could be the greatest guy in the world, but there could be a lot of other stuff. I remember, I'm thinking of a situation where my alarm bells were going off. There was a very well-known female spiritual leader, and she had partnered with a guy who was in the teaching and very much about like meditation and I'm this and I'm that, and all the wardrobe that matched everything looked like he was so spiritual, like he was into this whole trip. His adoration of her in public on camera was so over the top. I remember just getting that cringe thing, like, who are you trying to convince? It was so over the top. And this lady is so loving and kind. And, you know, she believed it because for her, in her understanding of love, that is how profound it feels. And that was exactly her blind spot, because she brought this person into her practice, gave him all this attention, created a name for him, and then he dumped her when he got this position that he wanted. I was uncomfortable with that. It can happen. I'm just saying this is not the way it has to be for you. But understand, please, do not make the mistake of thinking because I'm in this realm that we're all nice and playing good. Not to scare you, just to make you aware that there are people in all pockets of life that appear to be good and they're still human. They still have human emotions and human desires and sometimes greed and con. So when you find somebody with the values that are consistent, that have proven themselves to be kind and good, and you see this on a long-term basis, that would be somebody who would be worth your time, your love, and your devotion. I hope this helps you, Susan Winter for SusanWinter.net, because I know so many of you write me about manifestation and how do I find that loving, perfect partner. So if you want a consultation, go to my website. If you want to take a look at some of my books, Allowing Magnificence is kind of a much more revealing story about how I got here and my spiritual journey and my life journey. And so you can also listen to me on podcasts. Apple Music, Google, Spotify, all that, the Susan Winter Show. And if you have a video request, write to SusanWinter.net. Go to the contact page underneath the agents and look for the box that says video request. And maybe I'll answer your question on air. Thank you, everyone.